remember not to stand up.
Yes, yes.
See, these youngsters, they're very happy.
Yes.
They're just jumping up and down.
Yeah. Why don't they kill it?
It's a kudu.
Why don't they kill it?
It looks like it's killed. I mean, it's...
They're just waiting for it to die.
I think someone's probably suffocating the net. I think it's already dead. It's not been moving.
It's still moving, it's like, oh
I mean, it will take maybe like 5 minutes or 10 minutes and then it when they catch it, they go for the neck here and they suffocate it.
They suffocate
it? Yeah, so that the kudu doesn't breathe until it's finished.
So it's not the blood?
No, they just suffocate. Then they'll start to open it now.
And they start eating before it's dead, or?
Yeah, it's lots of lions. So the one will be suffocating, yeah, and the other ones will start eating. So guys, this thing that we just saw now, I mean, people come for many years and you can see. I mean, even for us, we sort of drive. I mean, every day, but to see a kudu coming and you see the actual catching, it's unbelievable.
Yeah.
We're very lucky.
Yeah. You don't care.
You didn't see us.
They don't care that we are here?
No.
Yeah. Now, and this injured female is slowly moving down. She's basically just at the back of my vehicle now.
The other, the number 9 one, is also coming.
Mm-hmm. Is she injured?
Yeah, she's got a limp.
Did you talk to the coach?
It's already dead.
He's already dead.
Yeah, it's already dead. They're eating. It's just that grass there. It's blocking our view. Maybe you wanna maybe tell your grandson to go and open up.
I need you just to ask.
Go and cut the grass.
Coincidence.
They were sort of walking to the spot that they want to relax for the rest of the day, and they see the opportunity and they start hunting. Normally they hunt during the night. They can still hunt if they didn't make a kill during the night. Early in the morning they can still hunt. But most of their hunting is
night.
Eight.
There are eight like us.
Yeah. Number 9 is still coming.
Yeah, breakfast.
Breakfast.
Yeah.
How often do they take a prey like this?
Like now, they're eating now, they might start to want to hunt maybe in 2 days, 3 days.
2 or 3 days?
Yeah. But you know, lions are very, cats, they are opportunists. Like they just eat now, they'll go and rest, and if something comes and they feel the opportunity to catch, they'll catch it.
Even if they're not
hunting? Even if they're not hunting.
Something,
I don't think she knows yet, but as soon as she comes closer, she'll hear them and she knows that probably sound is what they feel. Another female comes to them, so stay far. I can hear her calling. She'll soon come and join them.
Do you see things like this?
Not often. Not often. You know, most of the time we just see them from the first time.
See how they sort of just position themselves.
This that female that actually caught it, remember she was just standing there. She saw this kudu running, and then she came around so that the kudu ran to her.
She was just hiding in the grass.
She was just hiding in the grass, and the kudu just saw her like in a meter, and we didn't get a chance to jump on.
Kudu cannot defend himself against
the
lion.
No.
Ser du hans lite loss kött?
Ja. Jag ser det.
Not hungry. I mean, the stomach wasn't empty. Yeah.
And they are waiting 2 days before sending me?
Yeah, like if they're eating now and then finish, they'll sort of desperate towards hungry after 2 days. But you know, lions, because they don't always successful, they don't always catch. So even if they just finish the kudu, if a wildebeest come and wildebeest is coming towards them, they will also take it down, they will also kill it, because they don't know when they will kill again, so they just use opportunity that they have.
What type of injury does she have?
It's on a foot, or on a paw. It looks like on a paw. There's no scar or anything. Maybe she when she was running, maybe she stepped on a hole and she twisted her ankle. Very, very better.
Much better.
Much, much better. Female can live up to 17, 18 years, and the male can live only 12, 13 years old. Yeah. But also males can live up to 17, 18 years, but the reason is because they fight with other males.
Okay.
And then
someone else take their place.
Yeah, someone else take his place when he's about 12, 13 years. So
okay.
From that
12,
13 years. They can kill their father, but nature sort of take care of itself. Because if the sons kill their own father, which means they will take over his pride, and that is their sisters and also mothers. So the inbreeding will happen. So before they are strong enough, they sort of put pressure on them and chase them
away.
Yeah.
So they will sort of
build,
tell the children to go.
Basically. Yeah. Mm-hmm. By 3 years they leave their pride and they go out by themselves, and they can only establish their own pride when they're 6 years old. So that 3 years they sort of nomadic, they just go anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So by those 3 years, 4 years, they don't scent mark.
And how do you deal with that in here?
Sorry?
How do you deal with that in here when the lions, when they get like three?
What we'll do, because there's no other pride here, we'll sort of sell them all. We'll sell them to the other side. So we're left with one male and females here. Because the big male can mate with his own daughter, and the inbreeding doesn't happen. Sell these four males and left with these two youngsters, these two. start mating with the female. As soon as the youngsters leave, then the female will sort of go back to it. And then he will mate them, get pregnant for 90 days, 110 days, and then they will have babies again. But for now, because this 2 year old, they still see them as the youngsters.
Mm.
For them, they're still calves, they're still babies.
Mm.
That's why they, the male is not mating the female yet. Mostly they'll just eat one in a day. In a day. Because you see, this is a kudu. The kudu is much bigger, it's about this high. So I'm sure they would be sorted after this kudu. Yeah. They'll be fine and they'll just find a nice spot and they'll just lie down. So they'll be not moving, which means if they're not moving, then they're not hunting. So they'll only eat one a day. But because there are opportunities, if they finish here and they will go and lie down and clean themselves, and then if something comes into their way and they think they have opportunity that they can catch that animal, they will actually go for it. And if they catch, and then they'll catch and then they'll eat again. But for the second time when they eat, it's not going to be the same as this, because everyone is hungry there. So when they catch another one, the second one, they sort of take 10, and someone go and feed, they come back, go and feed, and sleep. But most, because it's very hard for them to catch, it's not easy. So just one a day is enough for them.
This time it seems like they were quite lucky.
Yeah, we're very lucky. Yeah, they were very lucky. I mean, those youngsters, they just saw the wallabies and the zebras there. And this kudu must have panicked, and then the kudu ran.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
See, there's a little.
He didn't know there's someone waiting for him.
Even big one.
He got a huge surprise.
You don't want to establish more than one flock here in the reserve.
No, yeah, it's gonna be too many lions, and then they will eat lots of animals.
Okay.
So the animal will go down, and the lion sort of go up, sort of balancing each other.
So one flock needs this big area for hunting.
Yes. This area, 15,000 hectares, it will be suitable for two tribes. But because of the mountains that took a lot of space, so there's no space for them to actually have two tribes here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But if it was an area where there's no mountains, I mean, this is a huge area.
Mm-hmm.
So you can have two tribes. So the other tribe will sort of cooperate on the eastern side and the other one on the northern side, or maybe on the western side.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yes, it's like steam rising from them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
From them growling.
From the heat.
Yeah.
Oh, is it from the lions?
Could be from the lions, or also from the kudu. Yeah.
They will eat once in a day.
Yeah, most they will eat once in a day.
One a
possibilité de toucher la moquette sur la ligne de chemin.
That we see is only one. The other one is very, very shy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I would say we have only one cheetah that we see often.
Okay.
I mean, not very often because it's only one and this area is big. So yeah, but we do see him now and then.
So there is a chance we could see him.
Yeah. I mean, it's always a chance.
But
yeah.
They don't hunt in so high grasses, so.
No.
It's not the grass is too high. Normally you need to see it.
Yeah, they need to see it, yeah. This is not a hunting area for cheetah. I mean, it's thick, the grass is tall, so they need a sort of a flat area. Yeah.
Yeah, they have a much easier
one
strategy.
One of the lion
yeah.
They just run.
They just run, yeah. So, sorry, you say? That other lion?
One of the lion is going.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think she had enough.
And one lion.
That's right, yeah.
Or she's hungry for the car.
Some
legends.
It's fresh blood in the car.
Yeah. With dessert.
You get from Belgium?
Yes.
Okay.
Are you all together in one big group or?
This is that's the one that actually made a kill, that one.
The one that left?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was smoothly done.
It was.
Took a few
well,
steps and
yeah.
She'd done it before.
Yeah. And it's so powerful. I mean, this kudu is big. It looks like it's got 3 10. Yeah. Just catch once and bring it down. Just like that.
Also, the weight of the lion is also.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. Sure. Very powerful.
To hurry now. Only be the horns left.
You won't find it.
Skull and bone.
Or maybe stop. Maybe she just arrested me.
They finish everything, right?
Yeah. They'll only leave skin.
That's a negative slip, she's calling, but I don't get
visual of her.
We see not photos.
Sorry?
No
tools? No, we don't have them.
No.
Yeah. We don't have vultures. Yeah.
You have rhinos?
We do have rhinos. We do have hyenas. We don't have those big ones, those spotted hyenas. We've got brown hyenas, small ones. Yeah. But those ones we have, they're only active at night. So during this time, we'll be when this lion leaves, I'm sure the jackal will sort of smell it. So smelly, so we'll come and finish it up. Whatever we left, like big bones and skin.
One more.
Sleep?
Just changing position.
protected layer against the water. Some old base.
It's not, you're not talking about the water bug?
Yes, talking about the water.
Yeah. Water bug mostly, they sort of stay close to the river or close to the dam. Like when the lion chases them, they go inside and they can swim very well.
Water
bug.
Is that the very big one?
Yeah. It's also quite big, almost similar size as kudu. Got a white ring on his back. And the target.
We have the bottom blue. Pink. Bottom. In English.
That
I want it for myself. Now it's really falling apart.
Yeah, it's almost finished.
Where are they going now? Are they going down to a river?
I don't think so. Maybe they'll just find a nice open and they start cleaning themselves there.
They don't need water to clean up?
No, they use their own saliva.
Yeah. But they start doing that immediately, cleaning up, I mean?
Yeah.
Any of them? Some ribs?
The steam is coming from the kudu.
Still hot and fresh.
Yeah, very fresh.
It would be nice to see the last one.
Yeah.
She can have some as well.
Mm. don't chew, they just cut and swallow.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, cut and swallow. When they finish, because the water is close by, they'll just go there and drink water, and then they will rest for the rest of the day.
Yeah,
yeah, they'll sleep.
Until tomorrow.
Until tonight. Yeah.
Tonight is another one.
Tonight they'll start walking again. Yeah. So try to see if they can catch another one. They finish here, they'll be full. We'll just go and drink water down there, and then, yeah, then they'll sleep for the whole day. And then tonight, maybe they will walk far, or maybe they'll just from where they are, maybe 100 meters, and then they lie down again. Yeah, these lions, it's not always that they will move far. They just move maybe 200 meters and they lie down. It's possible that maybe if we come tomorrow morning, they're not far from here. Or maybe it's also possible that when we come tomorrow, they will be far from here. Maybe they've already crossed the bridge and go that side. It depends.
They move around the whole reserve, or?
Yeah, they move all around the reserve.
It's another one bit one day.
You mean they will catch another one?
This is enough for today.
Yes.
And tomorrow another one.
Maybe. Yeah, maybe. They're not very successful. It's not like they always catch. Sometimes they try for maybe 3 days and still not catching. Today they were just lucky. I mean, it was quick actually. We were standing there for like 20 minutes and then they kill. Sometimes they go the whole night and they're not catching. They try, they don't catch until the morning. Well, maybe 2 days they're still not catching. So, but sometimes they can catch today and then maybe tomorrow morning they catch again. So yeah, it depends how lucky they are and how successful they are. But normally, lions are not very successful. Yeah. I'll say maybe out of 10 tries, maybe they catch like 4 times, they're successful for 4 times.
And they kill only, they kill only to eat. To eat.
Sorry, say again?
The lions kill only on to eat.
They only eat.
They don't kill for fun. They only kill for eating.
Yeah, they always kill to eat. Mm. Yeah. They always kill to eat.
They have enough meat for today.
Yes.
For one day. Tomorrow it's another one.
Yeah. Yeah, today they are all sorted.
And so they went further.
Yeah, like they already hunt here, and then tomorrow they will move to the other area and hunt into the different area. But also if there's animals here, they'll also try and hunt here. Normally they sort of move away, and because the animal will have already seen them here. So they sort of move far from the lions, because they know the lions are here. So they need to move from this area and go hunt into other places. And there's still a lot of meat there.
A piece of ears.
Yeah, and the neck as well.
Do you have any favorite parts? They start with
always they start with the ram. Uh-huh. Yeah, so that's their favorite part, is where the good meat is.
Mm.
Yeah, very muscles.
Mm.
Yeah, they always start from the back. The last part will be the head, and then
you're always fighting, not opening the bladder.
Yeah.
Because if the bladder is open, then the whole meat. Or?
Yeah. So they will first eat around, yeah, and then they will sort of take out the bladder and into the side. Yeah.
They don't eat intestines.
They do eat. They sort of squeeze out the down.
Mm-hmm.
So they'll they sort of squeeze out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, using their mouth, squeeze out and then they eat the intestine. But that will be the last part. Yeah, it's not their favorite.
Now
you can see. Over now. Seems like everyone is full.
Everyone is getting full. No more fighting.
Yeah. I believe the big kudu just in one stand.
Don't they care about us because they are used to people, or?
Yeah, they actually used to this car.
This car?
Yeah, with people sitting and taking pictures.
But if it would have been the first time they saw us, they would have reacted somehow. Right?
If it was the first time they see this car,
yeah,
they would have already run.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Trust us. haven't do anything, you haven't interfere with what they're doing.
Can they, do they catch all the animals we've seen today, like zebras and...
Yes, yeah, they catch anything, yeah.
Even small ones?
Yeah, even warthogs.
Okay,
yeah, they
even?
Go into the water.
Really?
Yeah, warthogs sort of easier for them.
Mm-hmm.
Warthog doesn't have a good eyesight and they can run fast,
mm-hmm.
So, yeah, they often go for it.
Is this the intro to film?
No.
Sorry?
This isn't the ninth female, right?
Yeah.
It is.
This is the one that killed.
Yeah, yeah, but not the injured one.
No, it's not the injured one. Yeah.
It's the mother.
There's another big one.
She's coming back for dessert.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she was just digesting and she's coming back.
Yeah.
It is much to eat, same for 8 lights.
Yeah, yeah, that was too much to eat. They all look